You're watching InTechnology, a video cast where you can get smarter about cybersecurity, sustainability, and technology.
Hi, and welcome to today's InTechnology podcast. I'm Camille Morehart, your host, and today's topic is endpoint vulnerability management beneath the OS. Very specific, and for that very specific topic, I have Novin Kaihani, who is GM of Intel's client software products group. Welcome, Novin.
Thanks for having me.
So we're just going to come right out and say you've announced a product late last year in 2023 that addresses vulnerability management in endpoints, which are things like PCs, underneath the operating system layer. But before we talk about the product, why would you be looking beneath the operating system? Isn't that already happening?
Yeah, great question. So much of what we see out there is around application and OS vulnerabilities that are covered today. There's quite a few vulnerability management services and companies focused in this space. It's a core piece of the security posture of an IT organization. But that is only half of the stack. OS and below don't really get covered very well in the market today because it's difficult to identify vulnerabilities with firmware, microcode, drivers. There's all different versions, different packages of BIOS. It's complex. And so what you see a lot in the market is OS and above because it's relatively straightforward and included in many of the security solutions out there. So what we've done is said, hey, there's an area that's uncovered in the market, and we have to make sure that the security posture of our endpoints is increased and making sure that the full stack is covered.
You're doing this in partnership. Intel's doing this in partnership with another company.
We announced late last year a partnership with a company called Eclypisum. And what we've done is we have a service where we make it easy to identify security vulnerabilities below the OS in the wild. And we highlight those vulnerabilities to Eclypisum's product that ensures identification and ultimately hashing or remediation of those vulnerabilities. Because that's at the end of the day, what IT cares about is that they're plugging those security holes throughout their entire stacks. So we've just made it easy to identify those vulnerabilities in the wild.
Because it's below the OS, so is that happening like at the chip level or the firmware level, or can you not say and it becomes unsafe?
Great question. So what we do is we identify what are the vulnerabilities below the OS, but we do it at the OS level. So we ensure that we can read platform information, understand, say, what versions of microcode, BIOS, firmware, drivers exists on the platform. We scan that platform data against our vulnerability database and then signal those vulnerabilities to companies like Eclypisum to be remediated. It sounds pretty straightforward. The challenge is identifying those vulnerabilities in the wild. Much of what exists out there is basically websites that catalog what vulnerabilities exist, but identifying those correct between what's published and what exists on a very specific endpoint, that's the hard part.
So you're going through, is it called CVE, if I'm remembering correctly? Okay.
You got it.
All right. I get my gold star for today, but
exactly.
So there's published known vulnerabilities that are made public. And then you're comparing, and these would be like libraries of vulnerabilities. Doesn't mean they've been exploited. Doesn't mean there's been an actual problem on your system. It just means the world has now become aware of this vulnerability and you're going through the libraries and cross-checking that with what the actual system is and whether or not it's maybe been patched or I don't know. What are you cross-checking it with?
We have a whole team of engineers that actually work to convert those CVEs into something that is machine readable or developer friendly, however you want to think about it, because there is what is published, but what actual devices and different versions of, again, driver, microcode, firmware exist, that rule set is what is very difficult to actually create and then match against a specific endpoint. And so it's not enough to have as part of a vulnerability management system a catalog of CVEs that's published. The challenging part is actually finding that vulnerability on a specific endpoint against a rule set that those CVEs represent.
Is this something that you do in an automated fashion, or are there engineers actually doing this manually?
So the rule set is kind of both manual and automated, but I would say probably more heavily towards manual, as they are cross-checking all the different versions of, say, BIOS and how those BIOS versions get manifested into actual packages that land on an endpoint. They're going through that entire rule set so that they ensure that there's no false negatives, false positives. When a particular system gets scanned, they are actually determining a specific vulnerability that may exist on that device.
And is this basically designed for like an enterprise level IT department or inventory, or we're talking consumer level?
It's meant for IT organizations or businesses of all sizes, really, because they are ones that are most at risk and have the most to lose if a particular vulnerability is exploited. We want to make sure that it's as seamless of an experience for an IT organization. So it's not a separate tool that you go download or install. It's built into the security products that they have today. And that's part of what we've done behind the scenes with our partnerships, is to make sure that we are providing that capability to the security solutions that IT depends on, so that it's built into those products. Again, so they're not having to download or install or maintain a separate application just for low the OS vulnerabilities.
Makes sense. And this is specifically for the PC, correct? Not other forms of endpoints?
That's right.
Okay. And so it's a vPro?
Actually, it's all the Intel PCs. It's vPro and any commercial device that the service would be applicable to.
Anything else we should know about it?
We're super excited. I know security is one of those areas that it takes a special person to get excited about. But at the end of the day, the more we can do to increase somebody's security posture, the better off the entire industry is.
Thank you, Novin. And we have some links below for anybody who might want to follow up and learn a bit more.
Thanks for having me.
Never miss an episode of In Technology by following us here on YouTube or wherever you get your audio podcasts.
The views and opinions expressed are those of the guests and author and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of Intel Corporation.